Here we go. Here it is again. I mean, it wasn't like I didn't talk about it last time or the time after that or the time after that or even the time before that. But here we are, my favorite game company from my childhood, just taking a massive dump right on my chest because apparently Mike Ybarra decided to go ahead and defend the microtransactions and predatory actions of Diablo Immortal as a statement. I mean, I don't understand how more tone deaf you can possibly get in the entire idea or concept to turn around and say that probably the most predatory video game in terms of trying to siphon money out of your wallet, literally, probably ever made, you're trying to defend now. Activision Blizzard, Mike Ybarra, CEO. World of Warcraft is an actual shambles. You're all banking on one expansion. Diablo 4, no one is trusting because of what you did with Immortal. And now you're going to turn around. and defend these practices that you put in Diablo Immortal. Now look, if you don't know what I'm talking about, I made a video about Diablo Immortal and how much it actually costs you, the player, or should I say the payer, in order to actually enjoy the game. Pro tip, it's over $100,000. Wow. So hey, look, check that video out in the description down below if you want to see that and my review of that game. Trust me, just don't even play it. But let's talk about Mike Ybarra now, because he had an interview recently with the Los Angeles Times, and wouldn't you believe it? The Los Angeles Times also has a paywall for the article. You can't make this up. You really can't. Anyways, let's go ahead and see what happened in the actual interview and what are the two choice quotes from Mike Ybarra as well. The article from IGN says, in an interview with the Los Angeles Times, Ybarra stood by the game's microtransactions, which he claimed were implemented to make the game more accessible. When we think about monetization at the very highest level, it was, how do we give a free, quote-unquote, Diablo experience to hundreds of millions of people where they can literally do 99.5% of everything in the game? You know, this argument that I hear all the time for free-to-play games or mobile games is honestly, in my opinion, sickening, and it's a stupid argument, by the way. Well, Alex, the game's free. How else are they gonna make money, Alex? They have to monetize you to hell in a handbasket all the way down the river. If not, they'd never make any money, right? The whole, like, you can play 99.5% of the game for free is complete and total bullshit. Because in less than the first hour of the game, the first thing that you're greeted with is the 800% value $1 chest. So literally, in the very beginning of the game, you are greeted with the cash shop. You are trained to go into the cash shop. They want you in the cash shop. That's where they want you to go. That's what they want you to spend money on. It's not about the fact that you can play 99.5% of the game for free. It's the fact that they want you to spend the money regardless of what they actually say in the first place. And now this whole thing about, like, we want to give an experience to millions of people. Diablo 3 sold millions of copies around the world at $60 freaking, and the game didn't work for the first week. It is literally them just trying to go ahead and say, oh, we're the good guys, we promise. We're not trying to scam you out of money. I mean, look, you got the game for free. Sure, but that doesn't mean you can be as predatory as you are in this game. You could have, I don't know, scaled a couple of things back. We didn't need 3 different battle passes. We didn't need to spend $25 freaking on legendary crests to run one rift. We didn't need someone to create an actual gem slot machine to tell us how much money people were going to spend before they get their first 5-star gem. We didn't need your pity system to not even give us a 5-star gem after 50 runs of the rift system in order to get one, and then it's just a chance of getting a 5-star gem, by the way, and then you go ahead and go into resonance. You see how it just continues on? It just stacks on top of each other, and it's just like, how do we get more money here? How do we get more money there? Oh, but it's free, you guys. 99.5% of it is free, and here is where we're gonna break down Ybarra's argument completely across the board in this next statement. As if I haven't done that already. Mike Ybarra also defended the way the microtransactions are implemented, as they are largely only come into play in the game's later stages. That's a lie. The monetization comes at the end game. That's a lie. Ybarra continued, the philosophy was always to lead with great gameplay and make sure that hundreds of millions of people can go through the whole campaign without any costs. From that standpoint, I feel really good about it as an introduction to Diablo. Mikey. Let's talk about Diablo itself as a game, shall we? People play Diablo not for the campaign. And you're thinking to yourself, wait a minute, what are you talking about, Alex? Why wouldn't you play for the campaign? You see, no, people play Diablo for the loot. The big old explosions, the colors, the runes, all the loot, the builds, the whole shebang. They run the same bail runs consistently all the time to try and get that one piece of armor that has a really low drop chance to complete their set. That's why they play Diablo. They don't play it for the campaign or the story. Oh, it's so good. Granted, I will say this. The lore in Diablo is phenomenal, and you should read up on it because it is really good. So yeah, the end game is the most important thing to a large portion of Diablo players. It's not truly the campaign. So let's backtrack on this a little bit here, shall we? Mike Ybarra said that you can play 99.5% of the game for free. But then Mike Ybarra also said the monetization comes in later on at the end game. Wait a minute, Mike. So what you're telling me is the end game, the literal most important part of any ARPG or Diablo game for that matter, is 0.5% of the actual game? Wow, that's not a great argument at all, is it? And then you have the audacity, the gall, the testicular fortitude to lie directly to everyone and say, oh, the monetization comes in at the end game. When at level 15, they give you the battle pass. Not level 60, not level 100, level 15. So don't tell me the monetization comes in at the end game. And when you first start the game, you can even go ahead and buy the monthly sub. And then you're given the 800% value chest right up front. So look, the lying, the deceiving, the bullshit has to stop, because this game is atrocious across the board. We know it's bad. We know you guys did a bad thing. Don't shit on my plate and then say it's tiramisu, okay? Because nobody's going to accept that. And anyone who does accept this, why? Why? Why does a mobile game have to treat you like a pay pig? Why does a mobile game have to be free and then actually at the end game cost you six figures plus? Why does a mobile game need to have gacha mechanics? No one can actually say why. Everyone just says it does. And that's not a good enough answer at all. So look, I love Blizzard. That's why I'm popping off in this video. But the thing is this, Diablo 4 has a lot to live up to. And right now, it is way, way down there. And Path of Exile 2 is gonna come out faster than you think. And that's gonna definitely eat your fucking lunch. So in my opinion, Mike Ybarra, Blizzard, Activision, get your shit together, because clearly none of you have any idea of what's going on. None of you play your own fucking games, and none of you can actually figure out how to talk into a microphone without sounding like a jackass. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you guys so much for watching. I know I went a little bit ham in this video, but either way, you know, some things have to be done. But if you want to see more of my content, subscribe to the channel. Now we're getting close to 28K subs, so I want to say thank you guys for all of that directly. And if you want to see more of my content, check me out on Twitch and Twitter. It is at, oh no, it's Alex. And if you want to join my Discord, you can either become a member on YouTube, a Twitch sub, or join my Patreon. Thank you guys once again so much for watching. Hope you have a great one, and I'll see you next time.